Hello guys, my name is Kiki and in this video I am going to tell you one of my sad story when I ended up buying a fake Eakins IMX290 sensor microscope camera. So let's get started. So until now I was using another Eakins. It's a small Eakins camera, microscope camera. It's also full HD. It works quite well, but in certain conditions, like low light conditions, and when I have too much flux on the board, things like this, and there are a lot of reflections, then basically this microscope camera is dead. It's not working well anymore. And I wanted you to have a better experience watching my video, to enjoy it more. So I was looking online since at least half a year or maybe a year on certain YouTubers repair videos, which camera shall I buy. Due to the reason I'm a hobbyist, I definitely did not want to pay 700-1000 euros, so I wanted to buy the best camera for my money. And due to the reason that I had quite good experience before with Eakins, and I saw that several YouTubers are using the Sony IMX290 camera sensors for their videos, and it works really, really well. My feeling was always that comparing all these camera views, I had the best experience watching these videos made with this IMX290 camera. So I was looking in the an AliExpress, eBay, everywhere, which options I have. And I also saw some reviews from an Eakins IMX290 sensor, or camera, basically, with this sensor. And at the end, I decided that, okay, I will go for it. I paid roughly 180 euro for this. It was clearly listed as an IMX290 sensor. I even wrote to this Eakins microscope store on AliExpress, is this for sure the IMX290 sensor? And they replied, yes, it is. So at the end, I ordered it and I was pretty excited to receive it. And when I received, it arrived in a nice box, nicely packaged. There were the camera inside, there were the power supply inside. It's nicely packaged with foam and also with an HDMI cable and a mouse that you can use to change the settings. And also some kind of a user manual, I would say. And then I connected it up to my trinocular camera, to my trinocular microscope, which is also from Eakins, by the way. And I realized that the picture quality of this camera is far, far away from the videos in the advertisements and from the pictures in the advertisement. Then I started to thinking that maybe I got scammed and I maybe did not receive the right camera with the right sensor. So I contacted with Eakins, but they told me that yeah, it is with the IMX290 sensors, no worries. And then I initiated a refund process because the picture quality was definitely not even close to the picture quality on the advertisement. And to be honest, in certain conditions, my old shitty 70 euro camera behaves way better than this one for 200 euro. And I was really pissed, so I initiated a refund process where basically they did not even reply at all. And I just initiated this for a lower amount of money like I paid. I did not want to ask for a full refund because I was sure that they will ask me to send it back, and I definitely did not want to send back for 30, 40, 50 euro on my own cost to China. So I thought, okay, I will initiate a refund process with a small amount of money, and they did not reply at all. So I won the refund process. I get back some money, but at the end I ended up having a shitty camera. That time I did not know if it's really an IMX290 sensor, or only the advertisements were wrong and things like this, but I was pretty disappointed. So let me show you the listing where I bought it, and let me show you also the quality with this one compared to this one. And then at the end I will show you how I figured out that really this is using a different sensor, a way older sensor than what is sold with or what is advertised with. So let me switch over to the screen capture and let me show you the listing. So as you can see, this is the AliExpress listing here. I paid something like 180 euros, sorry, not 190 euro for it at the end. I bought it from Eakins Microscope store. I have no idea if this is an official store or not, but I already ordered before from them. I think my trinocular microscope is from them. And then if I open the listing, then you can clearly see this is a full HD Sony IMX290 sensor. Again, full HD HDMI digital video microscope camera. And I ordered this version, 193 euro. Then here I can also show you there is a video. Okay, this is no really small, but if you check this, it's really high quality. It looks really, really nice. Later on, I will show you that the camera I received is not even close to as good as this camera here in these videos. And if I scroll down to the listing, some pictures from the camera. And again, some pictures which were, they claim to be made with the same camera. They are really high quality, way higher quality than the one I have. And yeah, okay, then let me put it onto my trinocular setup and I will show you what it can do in the reality. Okay, so as you can see, I put my camera onto the trinocular via HDMI. It's via an HDMI capture card, but I can tell you it's not the HDMI card, the HDMI capture card, which is making it worse. It's really the camera is shittier than it advertised. Okay, so let's switch over to the microscope camera view. And this is it, guys. Look at this, how disappointing is this picture quality. There is this shield here on the left, which is basically shining back a little bit, and it's making the picture so much worse than with my old camera. I will show you later on how it works with my old camera. There are a hell amount of reflections everywhere. It's really bad. If there is flux on the board, and no, basically the brightness of my ring light is on full. Now I connected up my mouse and I can change the settings. I was playing with this a lot, playing with the brightness. Now I'm increasing the brightness, decreasing the brightness. It does not really help at all. It's just bad. Now it's in automatic mode. I can set it into manual mode. Now as you can see, it's way, way brighter. Then I can remove it. I can reduce the brightness. Oh no, in this case, when it's in manual mode, I cannot even reduce the brightness. I can play with the shutter. It's slightly better, but still a hell amount of reflections everywhere. It's really bad, not even close to as good. When there are no reflections, then it's quite good, I would say. That in that case, it's maybe slightly crisper than my old one. But when there is just a little bit of reflections, then this is dead, and this is way worse than my other one. If I cover up here with my fingers, then it's slightly better. But still, it's really bad. I played already a lot with the settings everywhere, with contrast settings, with the sharpness, with the saturation, and so on. Everything with the gain, I can reduce the gain, but then it's already dark now. Increase it, that then it's just reflecting a lot. It's really bad. So let me know, put on my old camera and let me show you how it works on the other one. Or at first let me show you a blue board, for example, my old Samsung board. If I lean it slightly, then it's not that bad. But it's not even close to the videos in the advertisement. Switch it over. Look at this. Let's zoom in a little bit. And this is a closer look. As you can see, it's not good at all. I don't like it at all. My old camera can do roughly the same for less than half of the money, almost one third of the money. So you can see, as soon as there is a little bit of reflection or flux on the board, then it's really not good. This pad, you can just barely see the pads, basically, if there is solder on it or not. So let me switch over to my old camera and let me show you that it can do almost the same. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is now my old camera. It only connects via USB cable, basically, like a HDMI capture card is built in already. It's pretty cool. And let me switch over now to the microscope. And this is it, guys. As you can see, there are way less reflections coming back from the shield. I'm using the exact same ring light with the exact same settings. The picture itself is not as crispy, not as clear than the other one. This is definitely true, but I have way less reflections with this one. And it's way better to work with this one, as you can see here. This is significantly better, and this is a really cheap 70 euro USB camera. As I told, not as crisp, maybe like the other one, but less reflections. And I did not do any change on this. This is as it is. On the other one, you could basically not look at this shield because it was just so bright like hell and you could not see anything. But with this one, a little bit making the picture clear, I can see all the pads. Let's zoom in. You see here with this one, I can definitely see each and every pad, if there are any solder or not. It's just so much better. Then let's switch over to my Samsung board and to the blue board. Look at this. This is significantly better. Look at now the pads. With the other one, you could not tell if there are solder on these pads or not. And if I go closer, it's not good, definitely not good, but way better than the so-called IMX290 sensor, which is not true. I will show it later on. I can't really work with this one, but I wanted you guys to increase the video quality for my videos, so I invested money and it ended up wrongly. If I go here to the clean area, not bad at all. I think this one is, I can really tell this one is better than the other one for almost 3 times the money. Okay guys, and now I will switch back to my camera. And now I will show you how I know that this is a fake camera and it's not using the IMX290 sensor that is advertised with. And this is pretty pissing me off, to be honest. Okay, so let me take it apart. Basically, at first I will tell you the story that I was talking about this with one of my friend that I'm not really sure that is using the right sensor. And then he also looked online, looking around, he could find an article on maybe on Reddit, I have no idea, maybe it was Reddit, that a guy hacked this Eakins camera, or a similar Eakins camera, such a way that he can control the autofocus settings and things like this via serious connections. And I thought, well, if I could check this one on a serial monitor and check, and it would show which camera is this using, then I would know for sure that is this really the IMX290 sensor, maybe with a bad implementation, or this is really not that sensor. So I took it apart. Let me show this to you. I will switch over to the overhead camera. Let's take it apart. And in that article, the guy showed that there are basically three test points on the PCB. And with the help of this, you can connect it up to a USB to serial converter. Sorry, serial to USB converter. And then this way, by booting it up, you can check which sensor this camera is using. So I thought, okay, let's give it a go. I just removed this four. And that's it. It's basically a PCB with an HI. Let me see if I can show it to you. With an HI 3516. That is basically a CPU. And the first thing that I realized here, that was a little bit strange, is this one here. Look at these guys. This shows here that it's really the 3516 CPU, as we saw, and there is this 185 here, version 11 maybe. And I know that that Sony also has a sensor, a way older sensor, which is an IMX185 sensor. And then I thought, well, maybe this just shows which sensor is this using. But then just to make it sure, here you can see three test points. And in this article, the guy showed that these three points are one of them ground, the other one is Eric's and Tay's, and takes for the serial communication. So if I hook this up, to a USB, to a serial to USB converter, and I open this in, for example, in Termite, and boot these things up, then maybe I will see which sensor this is really using. So let's do this now. Let's hook it up. Let's measure which is ground, and the other one should be transmit and receive pins. According to the article of this guy, let's check it with a multimeter. Just let's find ground. Okay, so the left pin is ground. Then the other two should be TX and RX. So I already did this before, but I really wanted to show you live, basically, just to show you that really I'm not faking here the results, but this is really not what it's supposed to be. So I will add a little bit of solder to these pins. So the first pin, we already know it's ground, so I will just solder my wire to this ground leg here. on the HDMI port. Okay. And let me check then, the next one should be a transmit pin. It means that if here the next one is the transmit pin, I have to connect the receive pin of my serial to USB converter there. So the AD1 pin should be the RX. And AD1 pin is this one, and I will connect this to the second pin then. And then only one left, which is then the transmit pin, which goes to the receive pin. Okay, and now what I'm going to do, I will plug in this USB to serial converter. Okay, and I need the, I will need later on the power plug for the microscope, but at first no, I have to start the termite. Okay, so now you should be able to see both my camera and the termite program. Let's set it up. It's COM10, so it COM10, and now let's plug in the camera to prompt it to boot. And as you can see, it's already reading the data. And let's let it run. It might take a few seconds. And ta-da! Look at this, guys. Look at this line here. Linear no mode, Sony IMX185 sensor, 1080p 60, initial OK. So it means that I was right, that this is not the right sensor. I checked already online, and this IMX185 sensor is a 4 to 5 years older sensor than the IMX290. And it's with a totally different technology. And at the end, this is not what I paid for. So this is super annoying, to be honest. So yeah, that's it, guys. It's a pretty sad story. I was pretty disappointed, but I was happy that at the end I could figure out that it's really not the sensor. Not the IMX290 sensor, which is bad. But Eakins scammed me and sold me a camera with an older sensor. I don't want to go into details what this old camera sensor can do or what cannot do. I checked that it's really an older technology. The sensitivity of this IMX185 is way lower than the IMX290. And here it's definitely important. Low light performance is really important. So yeah, I do not know much about sensors, but anyway, this is not what I paid for, and this is really annoying. I do not know if this Eakins Microsoft store is really an official one or not. I have no idea. It looks like it is. I just wanted to show you my sad story and to warn you to take care what you buy and what you pay for, because whatever is coming from China, you can never be sure that you get the right one. And knowing this, I could really ask for a full refund. Because basically they just scammed me. But it's already too late, because I already opened the refund process way before I was aware of this thing. And it was already closed before I realized this. Okay, guys, so that's it for this video. I hope you found it helpful, and I hope you will not be scammed similarly to me. And I will promise that I will look for a good camera for the future, and I will try to improve my video quality. Hopefully next time it will be better. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you found it helpful. If yes, please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my channel. and I hope I see you next time. Bye!